Hello all, welcome to the next session on AutoSAR architecture. So today we will see a bit in detail about the different layers of architecture. So we know that all the ECUs in the car contribute their features to the overall functionality of the vehicle. Okay, when it comes to the AutoSAR platform software, let us see or let us go through some of the features that are expected of the AutoSAR platform software from an application point of view. Okay, so let's start with the first one, communication among application software components. AutoSAR platform software is supposed to provide a feature to communicate two different application software components. So there has to be communication between application software components. Okay, so this is one of the features. And next it comes to the communication between application software components with the basic software through RT. So RT is a layer which is in between, or the mediator between the application software components and the BSW layer. Okay, so this is one feature. And then the next feature is communication among different ECUs in a network. Okay, so the connected ECUs in a network have to communicate with each other. So this communication happens in terms of the signals and messages. One ECU transmits or receives the signals, and the other ECU also transmits and receives the signals. So this happens in the inter ECU. Okay, so this is one feature that needs to be handled by the basic software platform. And then we have management of different modes of an ECU or a vehicle. Okay, when we are talking about modes, there could be modes, for example, full communication mode, no communication mode, silent communication mode. So these mode constitute to a particular property or particular behavior of the ECU or the vehicle itself. And then we have management of network activities. What is the network activity? So for example, whether the ECU has to stay in a sleep state, or it is supposed to wake up and perform or participate in the network to transmit and receive the frames. So these are activities are taken care by network management modules. And then diagnostics. So the diagnostics tells the health of the ECU or health of the vehicle, if there are any problems within any ECU. So that can be handled by diagnostics. And then we have safety and security features, like so end-to-end protection, right? So these are all the features which are expected by the BSW platform software. Okay, so then how this BSW layer can provide these features? Okay, so there has to be a construction, or how these modules or how these features have to be represented. Okay, so these are all represented in form of layered architecture. Okay, so based on the relevance of the features, these features are categorized into several layers, and each layer containing a different modules. Okay, all these features are realized by a set of software modules grouped based on the relevance and applicability. For example, if you take the CAN communication, is handled by a set of modules which are segregated across the layers. For example, CAN driver, CAN interface, CAN state manager, CAN network management. So these are the different modules segregated across the layers. And then AutoSAR architecture is represented in multiple layers. Each layer has its own significance and purpose. Every module is a part of a layer in the architecture. Layered architecture with modularity helps in improved maintainability of the software. So we could say that, okay, we can implement all modules, CAN interface, CAN driver, CAN network management, CAN SM, all these modules together into a single module. But what happens is this will increase the complexity in maintenance or in understanding the module itself. So this layered architecture will help us in maintaining the module easily and will reduce the effort. Okay, so then this is how the AutoSAR layered architecture is divided into multiple layers. One is application layer, below which we have runtime environment, below that we have BSW layers, service layer, ECU abstraction layer, microcontroller abstraction layer, complex device, and below which we have actual hardware. So what is the responsibility of each layer? We will see now. Application layer. So application layer is a group of application software components and sensor actual software components. And the software components of the application layer communicate internally through RTE. So internally through RTE means, so application components can communicate among themselves through RTE, and also they can access the ECU resources, that is a feature supported by the basic software, through RTE. And this layer is microcontroller and ECU independent layer. Okay, below application layer we have runtime environment, which provides communication services for the application software components, sensor actual software components. Autos are software components communicate with other components via RTE. Okay, then this runtime environment enables implementation and mapping of autos or software components independent of a specific hardware or ECU. Okay, so this runtime environment provides the feature like portability, reusability. Okay, so that the same components implemented for one ECU can be made use of for other ECU, right? Then we have service layer. Service layer provides basic services for application and basic software modules to abstract the microcontroller as well as the ECU hardware from upper layers. So what are the services that are provided? For example, we have operating system, network management, memory services, diagnostic services, etc. We will see more in detail about these services in later sections. And this is partly microcontroller dependent, because when you talk about operating system is dependent on hardware as well. But network management modules like CAN and M are not dependent on the hardware, they are independent of the hardware. Then the next layer we have ECU abstraction layer. What is ECU abstraction layer? This provides access to hardware peripherals that are implemented either on chip or off the chip. On chip or off the chip means, so either it could be on the microcontroller itself or it could be out of the microcontroller but on the ECU. Okay, so this is ECU specific layer, making upper layers independent of ECU hardware layout. This is microcontroller independent but ECU hardware dependent layer. Then we have complex drivers. The complex drivers are basically used to implement the features that are not normally supported by the autos or standard. Okay, so for example, direct access to the microcontroller using specific interrupts and complex microcontroller peripherals, microcontroller and ECU and application independent modules. Okay, so finally we have microcontroller abstraction layer. So microcontroller abstraction layer abstracts access to the microcontroller peripherals, so be it a CAN driver or it's a LIN driver, flex ray driver, these are all the hardware modules. So this MCAL modules provide abstraction to this peripherals to the upper layers. So upper layers cannot directly access the hardware, but they always have to access through the MCAL. For example, CANF, it always must access the hardware through CAN driver itself. CANF cannot directly interact with the CAN peripheral. Okay, so this microcontroller abstraction layer is purely microcontroller dependent layer. Hope you have got a fair idea about the different layers of architecture. So we started with what are the features that are expected from the basic software module and how they are segregated into the layered architecture, and we have gone through the different layers of application autosar architecture and briefly have seen what each layer does. Okay, so in the next session we will get into more details about these layers and the modules in each of these layers. Okay, so until then, have a good time. Bye.